enough now, and maybe I'm not ready for love. Okay.
I've been trying to get in this location for, I think, like over a year now. It's simple. Something about the alignment, the symmetry, everything, the colors, it just,
yeah.
I don't know. I've always wanted to shoot here. And shooting here on film for this song, it just feels perfect. Yeah. This one is a little bit different than like the Warner and the Universal Studios ones, because this feels a little more realistic, where the other ones are very polished. It like sets, you know? Yeah, it's so cool being able to see it from our perspective, because a lot of people don't even know these things. Yeah. Like, you know, when you see a movie or something and it's based in a neighborhood or whatever, you think, you know, they shot that in a neighborhood, yeah, or whatever it may be. It's like there's sets for everything.
Yeah,
it's kind of crazy.
There's a whole neighborhood set, yeah, there's a whole city scene set, and yeah, people exactly. just think they're just,
it's a Truman
but
Show.
I mean, there's a Truman Show, but I always like doing that. I always like driving around and recognizing and seeing stuff I know from movies and TV shows.
If you have an eye for it, you hear about it, you're like, damn, that's crazy, this house is that. Like, for instance, we did this Trippy Red video like a year ago, and it was like an old New York street. They've done like a Seinfeld episode there, and like, oh, really? We found the episode afterwards and we watched, like, that's crazy. But that's, we just crazy. Naturally watch all these things, we consume them in different ways. You'd never think a Trippy Red music video was the same set as a Seinfeld. Yeah. So it's like you don't even register it, but yep, like there's probably so many things like that we don't catch.
So what's the concept of today's video? The
song is called So Done. It's about a breakup. The concept of the video is he gets broken up with at the beginning of the video, and it's kind of like the one that got away, and he can't escape her. So everywhere he goes, he's seeing her, imagery of her running into her and her new boyfriend. Yeah, it's just it's gonna be a fun but simple concept that, yeah, I think is gonna be relatable to a lot of people. Just breakups in general. There's certain like aspects and things, ways we're shooting it. I mean, obviously the film, but then some of the shots that are super stylized, that it's just gonna be tasteful. So I'm excited.
And it's Kid Laroi.
Yeah,
and he's on fire.
It's him, yeah, taking a step into kind of like a new world too, musically. You know, like, yeah, the song is, it feels different, yeah, than what he's done. Not too far left, but it's, you could tell it's a different sound that, yeah, he's stepping into. So I'm excited for him, man. I've been wanting to do this song for a while. I remember when he sent me this, because he sent me this and Tell Me Why and a lot of the songs off the Fuck Love project, but this song didn't go on that project because, yeah, they're like, yo, this is the one, we're gonna hold on to it. But this song feels like the one. Like, yeah, I feel like it could just be huge.
Renard Sharon, steady cam operator from Palm Beach, Florida.
How long you been doing that for?
2.5 years now.
So this is Cole's first time shooting film. No, it's a new chapter.
Joshua Borgoni, I'm a second AC. Loader today, since we're doing film. I just recently started doing camera stuff probably a year ago. It's my mentor, Alan. He's been teaching me everything. First AC.
Right here, on the camera. About to see it run if you want to come over here on this side.
Cool.
I'm Kilo, your first AD, and this is my key grip. Safety chief, if you see anything going on with our builds or anything, let us know.
Who are you? What do you do?
I'm Sal Tarantino. I'm the executive producer of Lyrical Lemonade and this music video, So Done.
What do you typically do as executive producer on a music video? What does that mean?
We're guiding the process along. We're working closely with the director and just executing on the creative, facilitating casting, working with our producer Krista on locations, and just kind of the run of the day, making sure we're in line with budget, communicating that with the label, making sure everyone's happy. If something goes wrong, it's on us.
You.
Yeah.
That's how I've been feeling, like, after the project's out for so long, this is what it feels like so long.
How long have you been out now?
2 or 3 months, maybe.
Has it been that long already?
I know, right?
That's fucking crazy. Is it a lot of records like So Done, like a different direction, or it's like...
No, it's like So Done, it's like a little bit of everything. The song on the project, it's like some more rap shit. The Young Boy song.
Young Boy song, sorry.
Yeah, I like that. That's the Young Boy one.
Is that the Young Boy
yeah,
one?
Yeah, where's
that?
There's
a different one they've been playing, though. Young Boy the only feature on it?
Young Boy, Marshmello. Yeah, Youngboy and Marshmello. Right. It's like produced by Marshmello and Scott Storch.
Classic shit.
Like, Scott Storch just like, we started the shit together and then just getting like Marshmello to touch it up and shit, yeah.
I think from above, looking down, so we'll see the room and we'll see you out here laying on the turf. And it's a shot where the sprinklers sprinkle on you too. But it's gonna feel as if it was in the other neighborhood.
Not a lot of people get to shoot on this stuff.
All right.
It's
probably expensive
as fuck,
right?
Yeah.
It's hard, yeah. Yeah. We do not even get to see the, like, anything besides through the camera. So this just gives us somewhat of an idea.
Like, what the shot is.
Yeah. But it's gonna look like cinematic. Honestly, it'll look more beautiful than, like, if we were to shoot how we regularly.
On a regularly, yeah. No, 100%. I feel like it's gonna look like fucking.
Yeah, it'd be
some
great.
Literal Tarantino.
Yeah, literally.
Roll camera.
Camera speed.
And action.
And look, Laroi. You know, see it. And you stop for a second, and then you kind of open up. But it's a matter of catching it out of that peripheral. Like you see it,
so
you know
I'm
what I mean.
Looking forward.
Yeah.
Like, and then I kind of like see it, and I'm like.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's all right.
And then just open up, hold still for 2 seconds, and then we'll be good.
Michael Stein from Los Angeles, California, and I'm the cinematographer for Lyrical Lemonade's So Done. So cinematography, I'm responsible for all the camera work and lighting, grip and electric department.
Okay. I realized now that everything that I did was wrong.
Let's get it, man.
Oh,
I'm ready.
You look better than me right now. No homo.
Thank you so much.
I can never look better.
We're back. We're back behind the driver's seat. The return. We were just talking about how when people put the two together, that this is the same, you know, it's gonna be a
fun perfect.
Moment.
Yeah.
I love it.
It's gonna be great for all the people.
And this is the same exact one from robbery.
This is.
It is the same one.
And it's the same man.
It's the same man behind the wheel.
If you watch the video, like you'll see Sal like glancing down while he's driving on that profile shot, you can see Sal in the driver's seat.
Yeah.
He's like looking down, it looks like he's like on his phone, but he just kept pressing the phone so the song wouldn't stop playing.
Yeah.
So he's like trying to tap it.
But it was crazy because like the song went out like the first two takes or something and he kept going.
Yeah,
he knew the song off the top like he was singing. He didn't lose a beat from like the song not playing.
That's cool. Crazy.
Good times, man. His next location is a scene, a set build that I've always wanted to do. A bird's eye jib shot that reveals two rooms at once. I'm using an exterior and an interior. So it's the idea that you can see into the inside of the home as well as him on the outside of the home. We obviously don't have a ceiling on the building, so it communicates like this. A feeling of a perspective we couldn't see unless it was, you know, imagination.
Yeah.
So it's something cool I'm really excited about. We're losing a little bit of daylight, you know, a little stressful. Working under pressure in times like this is when you make the most beautiful product.
So you got the tags on that shit still.
Yeah.
You know, this shit's expensive. We got the tag on it.
Gently worn.
Yeah.
Gently used.
Gotta return it tomorrow.
The same material.
Like an outfit?
Yeah,
like,
so you have a custom cut and sew outfit that's out of the same exact material.
Yeah.
I just looked at it, it's insane.
Where's it at?
It's over here, you wanna see it? Yeah. Well, let's get this shot done and then we'll do it. But it's crazy, bro. And it's completely custom. It's not like.
Oh, it's like one.
So fun. Bitches look like military, ready to go. How long until this stuff? It was my idea. I've been paying more attention to colors lately and coordinating sets with wardrobe. I had this idea for a few months of wanting to do a custom cut and sew outfit with a custom cut and sew backdrop that's made out of the same garments and materials. So the materials that you see on his wardrobe right now are the same exact materials that we cut this backdrop with. It's super cohesive. I don't know, I was wondering how it was going to turn out, like seeing it all together, but it's perfect.
I am Rashi. I work with Cody Fusina. I'm part of the Fusina Designs family and the Lyrical Lemonade family.
Let's get.
We started at like 5 in the evening just because, you know, just getting everything to us. It took some time. And we were at a shop till 2 or 3 in the morning, just making the 5 of us just cutting, pasting. Cole just said that I want to do a cut and sew backdrop.
Yeah.
I think it was a lot of muted colors, denim vibes, what kind of materials to do. And just go abstract with it.
Said I was, but you were the cause. For every little feeling I'm feeling inside. Sometimes I'm sitting, I think about why. Some things are better off said than done. Okay, I realize now, and maybe I'm not ready for love.
What's up, guys? It is 8:58. The premiere starts in 1 hour. The video is about to come out, right down to the wire. Got the footage in on Tuesday. And, you know, it's Thursday night now. Some last minute crunch time work. But yeah, so it's done. I feel good about it. First time working on film, 35mm. The ending, that's one thing I want to talk about real quick. The ending where the plane crashes, that was the original idea I had for the video, was that the plane was going to crash and a text pops on the screen and it says, sometimes heartbreak can save your life. But then my buddy Sal was like, yeah, I don't know if that's the best idea. Like, it's, you know, it's, people might be offended by that or whatever. And I was like, okay, maybe I should take it out. So took it out and I was just going to have we shot the scene of him sitting back down in the diner. And then after that, the girl comes and sits back down. That was how it was going to end. And there was going to be no plane crash. And then like five hours ago, I was like, you know what? I want to do the fucking plane crash. We got to do the plane crash. So put the plane crash in there last minute with just salvage some footage that made sense for it. And yeah, so that's the story of how that whole thing came together. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy it. That's all I got to say, man. I'm going to go to bed.